been mortified, fortified, fitting like a Mordecai. I ain't regular, feel like Jordan wearing 45. Traumatized, victimized, seen some of my niggas die. Knock you off a base with a bat when the bitch slide.
What's up, you guys? Today is day 2. I am about to go back to my apartment to take some things, but I thought I'd show you guys. I'm feeling better. My voice is better. Hopefully, you guys let me know. But here's what I have so far. So I am not gonna take this until the very end, but I just have some stuff in a box from my trunk previously. I'm gonna sleep there tonight for the first time, so I brought my little armrest. I'm gonna get a different color, but this is just the one I have for right now. Got a lot of stuff from my bathroom. I have Red Bull from like a month ago that I've had here, Powerade, water. Bringing my lamps because I need the lights. Got a stool, more stuff from my bathroom and laundry detergent. And I also have some dirty laundry right here to wash, a blanket I need to wash in order to sleep tonight. And then from the kitchen, I just took everything that was mine out of the fridge and put them in those two bags. I got a water that I need. And then I have some virgin olive oil. I got some eggs that I don't want to break. And then some liquid death, which is just canned water. So that's what I have right now. It's like almost 1:30. I have to go to work soon, so I am going to go to the apartment, drop everything off, go to work, and then come home and sleep for the first time there. I'm really excited. Probably put some stuff away once I come home from work, because I doubt I'm gonna be able to sleep as soon as I get home, because I'm just really excited to set everything up. So let's head over there now. Welcome back. This is what we're working with right now. I just brought everything in from the car, got my lamp. I got two more lamps right there. Let some natural light in. We have some kitchen stuff that's still here from yesterday. I put a lot of stuff in my living room to sort out yesterday night as well. And then I have everything from the car. We have some stuff for the fridge. I think what I'm gonna do is unpack everything, put it in the fridge, and I think I'm gonna order a pizza. I need something to eat before I go to work, so pizza it is. Got my trusty stool, the only seating I have in this house. I think I'm also gonna clean out the fridge before I put the food in there, because I didn't get a chance to clean anything yesterday.
We're open and ready to serve you. Yeah, we do have a special here for a $2
toppings for $23.99. Okay, I'll do a large pepperoni pizza. Okay, thank you. Pizza is secured. Let's unpack. Okay, this is the progress that I made. The kitchen is now blank. I put my boxes next to my room for right now, and I actually figured out how to connect my hotspot to my iPad, which I'm really excited about because it's gonna be a little minute until I get the Wi-Fi. Still have everything everywhere. It's just a little bit of organized chaos, mostly because I really wanna do an apartment haul video once I go shopping for a little bit and bring the rest of my stuff in, because believe it or not, this is still not everything that I have to bring. I definitely prepared myself for the best. I definitely had all of this already bought. There's very few that I actually went to the store to get recently, and if it is, it's kind of like last minute stuff. Most of this I already purchased between the past 2 years. You could say I've been anticipating this is an understatement, honestly, but I'm cool for right now. Someone just texted me. I thought it was a pizza man. It's my mom. So I'm just gonna chill with my hotspot, eat my food, and then go to work, and then a little bit later I'll come back and do some more with the apartment. All right, you guys, it is much, much later. Got my Spider-Man shirt on. Got my tea. It was very fitting that I used this as my first mug in my apartment. This is actually my aunt's mug that passed away a couple of years ago. And I feel like I have a lot of things that connect with her. So it just felt right to use this as my first drink in my first apartment. Technically, I had water and I also had soda as my first drink. As you can hear my voice from talking all day at work, it's just not giving. So I need tea to revive myself for tomorrow because I have to go to work again. Ginger tea it is. This is my electric kettle. I literally bought this like a year or two ago, right after I left college, or probably in the middle of it, honestly. It's like a little tiny tea kettle just for me. Britta, this is actually for Lucky, which is kind of funny. A lot of my things are for Lucky. I have his food bowls here. I just need to go to my mom's house and get his actual food and things like that, but I am pooped. I am more tired than I thought I was gonna be. Today drained me, literally though. I'm currently washing my blanket, so I can't go to sleep until it's done washing and drying. But I just discovered that there's a light in there, so it's currently on quick wash because that's all mama needs is a quick wash. I just want to be able to go to sleep. I've been really obsessed with the Family Guy newer episodes recently. I haven't watched Family Guy like in a very long time, like continuously. So I've been watching them for the past couple of weeks on Hulu. So I think I'm just gonna sit down and watch an episode on my iPad while I wait for my blanket to finish. What's up, you guys? I just woke up about an hour ago. I'm gonna drink another cup of ginger tea. This is my first night being here alone. It was definitely an experience. I had a really good time. There was not a lot of noise. However, as you can still hear, I am sick. So sleeping while sick, it is the worst thing. Hate sleeping while I'm sick because you just keep getting up. It was a journey. Regardless, I'm here. I got to sleep in my bed, very comfortable. Didn't even put on the mattress topper yet. And I love the way that it feels. I'm going to drink this tea so I can hopefully stop sounding like this. I ended up ordering a mirror the other day. It's the Hovet mirror from IKEA. I've always wanted one, and I ordered one literally like yesterday or 2 days ago, I think. I went to the IKEA store and ordered it through a team member, and then she said it was gonna get delivered today from 2 to 6 p.m. IKEA just called me and said they're gonna be here in 5 to 10 minutes, and it is only 12:21, so they are like 2 hours early or an hour and a half early, but go off, IKEA. I'm glad I'm awake and home because if I wasn't, I'll be so mad. I actually was planning on going to Target, but I was gonna hold off because I thought I was gonna have to wait around from 2 to 6, but I guess I don't have to. So he'll be here any minute now. He told me he's gonna call me when he's downstairs. I'm gonna move this stuff out of the way in the living room so that he can put the mirror in the corner. Okay, so I'm thinking the mirror will be right here in between the window and this wall. This place is relatively small, so I want to have a mirror here to widen it up. But yeah, he totally caught me off guard. I need to brush my teeth. I need to wash my face, not look like this. Like, what's going on? Oh, I don't look that bad. Okay, good. I'm still gonna freshen up, but I just turned on the camera because that was my first instinct to do. And I'm like, I look kind of crazy, but I have been looking a little bit crazy throughout this whole process, so. You guys should be getting used to it. Let me brush my teeth. I have to find my toothbrush. I packed it yesterday and I don't know where it is. So this, oh, it's right here. Okay, good. I was about to say, wouldn't that be tragic? I'm gonna go ahead and brush my teeth and wait for the IKEA delivery guy to call me back. You can put it right here. You can keep going forward. It's in the living room in the corner. The corner right there. Oh, wait, I can. Gotcha. You too. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm going to unwrap it and see how I want it placed.
Got me obsessed. Got me obsessed. You're getting better with the times.
smoking on your herbs, tasting like some fine wine. X broke your heart, you can hear that through my mind. Nick be calling, but you never mind, cause you all mine. Pull up to my house late night, hit the brake lights in the shade right. I know what's up on your mind. Pour a couple shots, put the Henny in my cup. And a couple moments later, we'll be winning up a twine. Something that's divine, had to give it time, but I'm patient. I just wanna sleep on your spaceship. Plus you down to earth and you never on some face. Didn't have the bill, had the women did impatient. Basic, we should take a time, but you pace it. And you one to one, God ain't on no copy patient. Felt so many times, this is different, we can make it. Love dripping good off of you, let me taste it.
Okay, now that the mirror is here, I'm reevaluating it and I'm wondering if I should put it in my room instead because the mirror is bigger than I anticipated. So it's taking up a lot of this wall space and I can't really put it in the corner because there's a ledge right there and it won't sit properly. So I'm thinking maybe I'll put it in here. Please do not mind the mess. There's just stuff everywhere. I couldn't find any tissue, so I got toilet paper. It's a mess. I'm thinking of putting it possibly in that corner or this blank wall right here. It's just a little bit too much. Unless I put it in that corner over there. Actually, let's try that corner first and see what happens. Oh, I like this a lot better. Okay, I do like this placement better. I think this goes better in this space. I think I can be able to have the mirror on that side and the couch over here perfectly. I'm gonna measure it again just to be sure. We shall see, but I really do like this placement of the mirror, so I'm gonna leave it here for now. Okay, you guys, we have a turn of events. Sorry for the loud noise in the background. That's actually my microwave. But I just looked on Wayfair because I started doing calculations with the mirror and everything. I stole my dad's tape measure. Thanks, Daddy. And I realized that the sofa that I wanted, the one that I took you guys to the store for and measured, it's actually pretty much the size of this entire wall. And I don't want the place to look too cluttered because number one, it's just not a good look. Number two, I have a dog. So I want him to be able to walk around at least a little bit in the apartment, especially because it's going from a house to an apartment. So I'm trying to make him as comfortable as possible. I found a couch on Wayfair and I was a little bit skeptical about buying couches on Wayfair. However, this couch, it looks so good. It's like the same material as the one that I previously wanted for half the price. And also it doesn't take up the entire wall. I just measured and it's about 94 inches. The other one is about 146 inches. So with that being said, I think I'm gonna order this now as well as part of my bed frame because I kind of want to sit elevated up. And now that I have the extra cash, I think I'll be able to do that. And I think I'm gonna put it along this wall. This way I'll have more room to put other things. I might get a coffee table, I might get an ottoman. And then I think I'm also going to get possibly a pantry. I was looking at freestanding pantries the other day, or I think last night actually, and I found this one on here for $132. This is what it looks like. It's really, really cute. As you guys can see, I don't have a pantry. I was planning on getting a bar cart possibly for this space, but now that I see the pantry, I could hide a lot of my food inside of the pantry. It would just look better and I would have more storage for all of my dishes and mugs and everything that I actually want to put in the cabinets. That's the one thing I don't like is that it didn't come with the pantry, but I'm actually not that mad about it because I think I can fit a pantry in here. That's my microwave yelling at me. Hold on a second. Okay, so the pantry, we're definitely getting the couch. That is a given right now. That burned me. All the reviews on the couch say that it's good. I can always return it, but I'm hoping for the best. Okay, so 110 inches is still not touching this mirror. So I think I'm gonna risk it and get both. Just because I really do love that pantry and it does come out like right next to this mirror. This is the one that I saw. So it's on sale right now for 16% off. It's $295 for this set. And you get the headboard, sorry about the siren. You get the headboard as well as the two nightstands. I'm really excited about it.
Okay. A youngin' that used to live for the summer, skip meals to go run amongst all his peers. Now fast forward up a few years, that giddy little kitty grew up and all of a sudden had to pay bills. My current dichotomy grown from pure curiosity. Guess I didn't know that part of the deal or know how quick it get real. Feeling so fleeting, me and myself need a meeting to make it
see clearer. Conversate with the mirror. Watch your language when talking to me. I'm the one that's with you. Speak some life in the self. You should opt in the optimism when options turn into prisons. Getting off of the slimmest pickings. Remember this place we in is a thief of joy, yeah, to steal. But no matter how much it take, I got more to give.
I know that this world is all I'm giving, and all of these thrills don't count for living. A little more will is all it takes, so I persevere, I'm not afraid. And right when it's falling off, not all is lost. It's giving me chills, I got a feeling. I gotta see stars and cars on whipping, cause none of my dreams involve a ceiling.
I seen a child raise a village, and he didn't come from no privilege. That made me conquer some limits. I've arisen from prisons, head on collision with visions I had back then, it was written. I've been walking in purpose, I've been coaching myself on life, telling me that it's worth it. There's some things I'm still gonna improve, and the timing is perfect. Still paranoid that I make it lose, like some toxic been lurking, anticipating my every move. On the back of my shirt is a target made to play me a fool. I won't fall to the serpent. Swear to God, I've been working like a doctor and surgeon, trying to piece together the pieces and heal up what hurted. My vice suffice till it don't, it shows. My passion might lead me out to where life is an open door. Sometimes it just takes
it take a little bit more to keep me right. Oh, wish you the best if you ain't know this would be like. But I miss so much the days we was rolling for pins on bikes. And Lord, it didn't miss some nights, but I'm growing inside this world and keep rolling.
I know that this world is all I'm giving, and all of these thrills don't count for living. A little more will is all it takes, so I persevere, I'm not afraid. And right when it's falling off, not all is lost. It's giving me chills, I got a feeling. I gotta see stars and cars on whipping, cause none of my dreams involve a ceiling.
Back to the basics, been a lot of things, but I never been basic. Run around bases, came from the basement, never been shameless. So I got stay in the streets, get dangerous, so I might bang it. Don't like hanging, less you family, please don't claim it. Like what you claiming, what you saying, what you buying, what you need. I'm at the house, ain't at the club, I'm really chilling with my seed. I love my poppy, put me on, I'm really chilling with OGs. Don't test my gangster, think I'm, man, we gon'
try to be here for a while in a good time, but we ain't stressed out, just good wine. When I look in the mirror, y'all look fine. Good people, times, and good wine. Good wine. Tryna be here for a while and a good time, but we ain't stressed out, just good wine. When I look in the mirror, y'all look fine. Good people, times, and good wine. Good wine.
Streets get ugly, yeah, I seen it. Please believe me, I be tugged. Don't like smoking, last so long, so I keep sipping on this cup. Don't crave attention, just to mention I be chilling in the cut. Glass got empty, now I'm searching through my wallet for a buck. Dollar bill, and some change in my pocket, oh no. Hit my girl, can you spot me? I just need a little loan. Out the house and I'm just vibing, vibing, vibing on the low. She said she on the way, but she gon' ride it, ride.
Tryna be here for a while and a good time, but well, we ain't stressed out, just good wine. When I look in the mirror, y'all look fine. Good people, times. Good one.
I'm over it, so I'm gonna get a mat so I don't bust my eyes in here.
Wow.
I've been preparing for this apartment for a long, long time.